So, as you were saying, everything in this part of the museum was something you could purchase at one time.
Yes, exactly.
So is that how...
We're at the magical Brighton Toy and Model Museum to ask whether a facelift of Trafalgar Street underpass could combat screen addiction among UK kids.
This new project will open up what is a dream, really. It is a fantastic thing, this, you know. I mean, there are no other museums of this sort, probably in Europe.
Trafalgar Street is tarnished with years of graffiti and layers of old posters, and it's getting a regeneration. A mural, new glass side panels, and a good old-fashioned clean is hoped to take the area from a back alley to a tourist hotspot. This should also have the added benefit of bringing more visitors into the museum, meaning kids who spend a lot of time on their screens can come in and experience something completely different. It's something clearly close to the heart of museum founder Chris Littledale.
If you get the sort of the age group, say, over six, say, six, seven, eight, that sort of age group, some of them you'll find are very excited. The little ones, it's just a playground. But for the slightly older ones, they start to take an interest. And I really try and encourage them to, yes, get yourself something to mend, make, paint, do something with, to use your hands, to take your eyes off a screen. Because everybody's just on a screen all the time, and it's a pity.
The average British child aged between 5 and 16 years spends on average 6.3 hours on screens a day.
But I spray a thing like that and then mask it. But then the trick is all that lining.
Wow. I don't know how you'd keep a steady hand.
Well, you do use a bow pen and it's not easy.
It doesn't look it. I'm in awe.
People are losing the use of their hands. And these things... whether it's construction things or train sets or whatever it is, or dollhouse furniture and all that stuff, it all needs manipulating in some way. You use your hands with it, even if it's to straighten the leg out of on a chair or something, you know? It all needs hand work, which is very good for the sort of the eye relationship to your hands and doing things. Right.
Wow, no, it's so fun seeing the like little pots of paint and everything.
Yes,
and
well, here we are. This is the workshop. This is where quite a lot happens. I've restored so many things in this little room for the museum and, of course, for other people. This all came from the same collection. There's even more.
Oh, my, wow. God.
And all this glassware. You see, tiny.
Glass? Incredible. Wow.
Yeah, it'll... it's all glass.
Take it from someone who's worked with toys their entire life. While screens can come and go, the fun of a physical toy never stops. Hopefully, thanks to Trafalgar Street's facelift, more will be learning this lesson than ever.
Working with old things, well, it doesn't have to be old things, but working with things is therapeutic. Incredibly satisfying to sit down with something and manipulate it or do something and improve it or do whatever, make something for it. And there are kits now coming out. There is a slight leaning back towards some of the things we used to have and do, because I think some people, quite a lot of people, are getting a bit fed up with this lack of this way of life. And there used to be lovely model shops in Brighton. There were several lovely model shops you could go to and buy cars or airplanes or little helicopters or building sets. And people used to go in there and it was a little bit of an Aladdin's cave. It's all gone. We need that, you know, and I think, yes, and I think if we can encourage people, we have a shop, people, plenty of parents come and buy their kids a train set, you know, and that's good. I like to see that. Now, people have said, can you show me how to colour match? And I almost say, no, I'm not sure I can, because I think it comes from here and it's your eyes and your...
I mean, it's an artistic skill, isn't it?
It's an ability, I suppose.
Mm. And for Chris, a man obsessed with detail his entire life, the regeneration of Trafalgar Street could be the biggest and most important detail to his business and life to date.
Anybody coming in here of any age group and seeing these things, if that helps them with a hobby or interest or creativity, whatever it be, it's very good. It's very good. Oh, for the community, I think this is incredibly important. It really is. And it must live on.